Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Normally on this channel, I review astrophotography products, whether it be equipment or software or gadgets. This time I'm going to do something different. This time I've bought a scope for use with visual astronomy. I bought a 10-inch F5 Dobsonian. I've chosen one that's for sale from StellaLyra, and I've picked it up from First Light Optics here in the UK. So in this video, we're going to unbox the telescope. The first shot was, having done quite a lot of research about the size of a 10-inch scope and umming and ahhing between an 8-inch and a 10-inch model, I'm slightly surprised that the boxes that have arrived are huge, particularly the one carrying the optical tube. So we'll open them up and we'll see whether there's an awful lot of packaging or whether there's an awful lot of telescope inside the boxes. Okay, so where do we start? Well, you'll get two boxes delivered. This one is around 2 foot square, maybe 5 inches in depth, and it weighs upwards of 15 kilos. And it's going to contain the base of the Dobsonian in a flat packed form. So it's shipped flat, obviously it makes the base that much smaller. And then the monster here, that's the optical tube. This is a steel tubed Dobsonian, a solid tube. So it's not a truss or a flex product. So basically the tube itself dictates the size of the box, and hence it's sort of 5 foot in length, and this has got around 20 kilos shipping weight on the tube. So both of the boxes, they're identified with an item number, which in this case is GS880. So that is telling us about the original source GSO for this telescope. So I'm going to do something I don't normally do. I'm going to open this one first and build the base. Now normally I'd be straight into the telescope box itself, but I'm conscious that it's a large scope. I want to have somewhere to put the optical tube as soon as it comes out of its packaging. So we're going to build the base first, try and follow the instructions, break the habit of a lifetime, and see how easy it goes together. So I've emptied out the box, and this is what we've got inside. We've got two of these side panels for the base. One of them has a couple of screw holes to fit an eyepiece rack there. You can see it's got room for 1 2-inch eyepiece by the looks of it, and 3 standard sizes. There are two of these round plates. One is obviously going to go on the ground, and the other one, the side panels will screw onto that. And then in between, it's going to be some arrangement of these other 3 items here. And if a quick look at the instructions that I've printed off, then you can see that we've got this one here, which is basically these are acting as bearings here. Hopefully you can see that these rotate, and they're going to sit in between these plastic discs. Are they plastic? No, actually I think they're metal. They're metal discs. They're going to sit in between those on the base. And then finally, in terms of major pieces, we've got panel here to complete the base, and a handle, which is a nice feature, and a bag of bits. We got some feet, some bolts that are going to go together with an Allen key that is supplied, and some other bits and pieces. So that's it. Let's try and put it together. Okay, so here's the base. Only a couple of operator errors putting it together. Seems to turn okay. All screwed together with this central knob. We can see that there's a bit of felt on one side of where the scope's going to sit in, where the bearing's going to sit. And here's the handle. So here it is. I've opened it up. There was a box inside a box, fairly standard, and you can see the optical tube. There it is, StellaLyra on the side, nice black tube. What else have we got? We've got a few bits and pieces here inside the end packaging. So this particular scope is packaged with 2 eyepieces. So this one is, you can see, a 9mm plossel. Okay, and this one is a 30mm super view. It's all made in Taiwan, and this is a 2-inch eyepiece, so a big chunky box, not too heavy though. What else we got? So the scope comes with an extension tube, which we'll attach a bit later to go in the focuser. And it has a battery holder box. So this scope is supplied with a cooling fan to the main mirror. So I understand that you can power it if you want through this using AA batteries, which were not supplied, but that's okay. And then if we go along to the other end of the box, we can see at this end, we've got two quite substantial fittings here, and these are going to attach, I think, on either side of the optical tube. So they're packaged in the end polystyrene, and we'll come to those when we take the scope out. Other than that, it's well packed. We take out the polystyrene. Not a huge amount more to see. Okay. Oh, actually, there is something else here. Not sure if this is packaging. Okay, there's another box, mystery box. Well, we'll come to that. See what's inside there in a while. You can just see the focuser there, all wrapped up in plastic. So what I'll do is I'll take the tube outside, take the wrapping off, and then we'll have a closer look. Okay, so out of the bag, our first impressions are that the scope itself is supplied in a rather nice gloss black paint finish. You can see here the fittings I mentioned on the side. We'll come to those that we're going to fit the mounting bearings to. And then here's one of the features that attracted me to this scope compared to some of the other 10-inch Dobs on the market. It comes as standard with a 2-inch Crayford style focuser, and it's a 2-speed unit as well, so it's got a 1/10 fine adjustment. Excuse all the noise, it's just a cardboard. By this point your house is full of cardboard and polystyrene. And in addition, you can see here that there's a finder bracket on the side. I guess that's the clue to what's in that other little box we found just now. We'll open that one up in a minute. Other than that, yeah, looks very smart. I'll take the tube out so we can have a closer look. Okay, so just because it's pretty unwieldy when it's inside the box like this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually follow instructions and attach these fittings that I showed inside the polystyrene. I'm going to attach those to the tube using a couple of screws that are provided here. And you can see the idea of this is that the point of rotation, in fact, can be adjusted up and down the tube. And I understand that it's supposed to be to allow you to balance the scope as you maybe put heavier eyepieces on or other accessories. So that seems like quite a nice feature. And it's got a graduated scale on each of these attachment points. So I'm going to go ahead, screw these on before I take out the tube. Okay, so note to self, this scope is big and I've got to work out a way of picking it up. So once it's out of the box, it located onto the bearings, the attachments to the base fairly easily. There was a loosely held cover, dust cover, shipped inside across here, touching the vanes. Quick look and see, you can see the primary mirror. It's got a helpful spot in the middle. Everything looks to be basically as expected. see the three screws there on the back of the secondary holder. Folks, it looks smooth. Coming around the front, we can see the branding on the focuser there. It's got a graduated scale, which is always nice to have. And I've got to progress to attach the finder, and then everything will be complete. But first impressions are good. If I try to tilt the tube, well, it rotates a little bit. Maybe when we've loaded up the finder and the eyepiece, it will be just right. But clearly we've got a mechanism to adjust that. Okay, last couple of things and then we're done. Okay, so I've unpackaged everything. So looking at the mirror cell, you can see here there is a DC motor, a fan attached to the back of the cell, and as I mentioned before, it comes with a battery holder here which you can plug in the power just so. I've got large chunky collimation knobs, which are it's good to see. So these are the supplied eyepieces, SuperView 30. I'm hoping this has got good eye relief because I wear glasses, and that's so I'm looking for some low power, comfortable views from this Dob. And then the 9mm Prosser, well, obviously for higher power, not so sure how that's going to work out because it's, I think it's 6mm eye relief, so we'll have to see. That probably be a little bit too small for me. One of the other nice features of this scope is that it comes with a right angle, correct oriented finder as standard. You don't have to pay extra for this. In this case, it's an 8x50 unit. And I think it looks very smart and saves you a few quid. When you're comparing these scopes, you've got to look at the details of the spec, looking at the focuser. Do I need a dual speed? Do I see myself upgrading to one? And pretty sure you're going to need a right angle finder to make this sort of scope much easier to use than a straight through finder. Okay, so stop the clock, that's it. This is the StellaLyra 10-inch F5 Dobsonian, supplied by First Light Optics here in the UK, and it's gone together in probably, I don't know, I've taken a couple of hours to do it. You could certainly do it quicker if you weren't trying to film yourself in the process. So first impression is very good. I picked up this scope because I wanted to try a larger aperture visual scope, and I wanted to look at the spec of this model. So it's been spec'd, I think, very well. It's got a dual speed focuser, the right kind of finder, and out of the box, it's all gone together very well. Bit like building flat pack furniture, got to be prepared for that. Get out your screwdriver and your Allen key. Other than that, just the size of it, it's big. Not a comment on any on this particular 10-inch Dob, but in general, these scopes are very big, and maybe I can see some wheels or a trolley in its future, but we'll see. So if you haven't yet subscribed to Gems Astro, please click the button now, and I plan to make some more videos when I've used this scope some more, gives you some first impressions on collimation, quality of the optics, and general ease of use. So, okay, so thanks for watching. Hope it's been useful. Bye for now.